3 phone calls to Rob Collie to solve this one. Pivot table, total of minimums. Great question from Illia K. Has a pivot table, changed the revenue to min, but you see the grand total is just giving us the smallest revenue in the entire data set. Is it possible to have all of these be the minimum of each sector, but the grand total be the sum of the minimums? Again, thanks to Rob Collie, his best-selling book on Power Pivot, Power BI, and DAX is right there. Okay, so here is the steps, 12 steps to make this work. Here's our original data. I have to convert this into a table, so Ctrl+T to make it into a table. My table has headers, definitely. And they're going to create background table design in a table called Table 1. I'm going to give it something more meaningful. I'm calling mine Bill Data because my name's Bill and this is my data. All right, so that's make it into a Ctrl+T table, name the table. And then we're going to go to Insert, Pivot Table. Super important here. You have to check the box for add this data to the data model. And we'll put it in an existing worksheet right there in column K. Click OK. Choose sector along the left-hand side. But I'm not going to choose revenue and convert to a minimum. That would create an implicit measure, and I want to create an explicit measure. If you have the Power Pivot tab showing, you can come here to Measures, New Measure. But I'm going to assume you don't. So over here in the Pivot Table fields, find the table name, Build Data, right-click, Add Measure. The first measure is going to be called MinSales. And we're going to use a function called equal min of, what did I call it? So I just start to type revenue. And right there, build data revenue. Check DAX formula. This formula has no errors. Ah, hey, we can even set it to currency, 0 decimal places. That's cool. Nice. Now, because I did the right click thing, it doesn't automatically add to the pivot table. That's okay. Just come down to the end of the list. We have our min sales, still the wrong answer there. Here's the next step. Now we're going to create the measure that's actually going to work. You have to create this measure first because the second measure relies on that. So we'll add a measure. This will be called min sales with sum of mins. You can call it whatever you want. And this is going to use not sum, but SUMX. SUMX is an iterator function. It iterates over each item in the first argument. So in the first argument, we're going to create a table on the fly of all the sectors. So we use the values of the sectors. That's going to, in this case, generate how many items? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that creates a tiny little table on the fly of 7 items. And then for each sector, we want the min sales. I typed the left square bracket there to get a list of all of the fields available to me. Min sales, close paren, currency, 0 decimal places. Check the DAX formula, has no errors, click OK. And then down here, choose the item. And there are the minimums, just like the regular pivot table was giving us. But when we sum those up, if I choose these numbers, 13,484, the grand total is correct. And then the last step is remove min sales from the pivot table. It has to exist in the data model for this to work, but it doesn't have to be in the pivot table. All right, so there's the steps, 12 steps in order to make that work. Go ahead, pause the video, screenshot those steps, give it a try, follow this exactly, and you should get the answer. Well, hey, my thanks to Rob Collie. Thanks to Illia for sending that question in, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. If you like these videos, please down below like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. A cautionary outtake. For those of you who think you don't need that extra step with min sales, if you just try and do the min build data revenue inside the SUMX. So we'll close that paren, close that paren. Currency, 0 decimal places, check DAX formula. Click OK. It sure looks like it works, right? But if you don't test it. Look at this, 13,484, and that grand total is not correct. You have to do MinSales first and then reference MinSales in the second measure. Where does the 11,928 come from? First thing, take the min of the entire data set, that's 1704. Then we're iterating over the number of sectors, seven sectors. The product of 7 times 1704 is why we're getting the 11,928.